Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you 4-bit adder subtractor circuit. So what I'll be doing is I'll be considering two datas that is having size of 4 bits. Let us consider A and B that is having size of 4 bits. Now what I want is I want to add and subtract these two data. So let me show you how we will be performing it. So let us say you want to add this. So Z is equals to A plus B, right? So that is what addition that we will be doing. And let us say you want to subtract that. So Z will be A minus B. Now, my dear students, one thing that you should know, like computer cannot do subtraction directly. And you should know, my dear students, addition circuit that is possible with computer, but subtraction circuit that is not possible directly. So how we can make circuit for subtraction? So for that, simply you need to consider that B as negative data. Like you see, what I'm saying is, as if you want to perform A minus B, then you can say you want to perform A plus negative of B. So in computer, how we consider negative data? With the usage of 2's complement. Let me show you how we will be performing that. So A minus B means what? A plus negative of B means 2's complement of B. Now, how to identify 2's complement? 2's complement means 1's complement plus 1. And 1's complement means it is inward data of that given variable. So here, this 2's complement of B, that is B bar plus 1. Right. So when you want to perform subtraction at that time, what you need to do? A plus B bar plus 1. And when you want to do addition at that time, what you need to do? A plus B, right? So that is how usually we perform addition and subtraction. Now how we will be deciding whether to perform addition or to perform subtraction? So that is there based on variable C. Let us say C is equals to 0 decides that this A and B that should be getting added, and as if C is equals to 1, then you want to do subtraction operation, right? So now I'll show you how we can have this by having circuit. So for that, what I'll be doing is I'll be considering 4 full adders. So let me write that over here. I want to consider 4 full adders. Now with this 4 full adders, what I'll be doing is I'll be giving one input as A. Let me show you here, one input is A. And my dear students, if you see, initially I have told you this A and B that is having size of 4 bits. So what I'll be doing is I'll be writing this as A0 over here. That is LSB of data A. This is A1, this is A2, and this is A3. This is MSB of data A. Now what I'll be doing is I'll be giving second input to this full adder. And that I'll be giving with the usage of XOR gate. After that, I'll show you why I'm using that with XOR gate. Let me connect that first. So here, one input to this XOR gate, that will be data B. So that is B0, B1, B2, and B3 over here. And second input to this XOR gate, that will be this selection bit. Right. So let us say that is C over here. Now, first of all, let me explain you the basic property which is there with XOR gate. Right. So for that, first of all, you should know how truth table is there with XOR gate. So here, let us say here I'm having C and here another input is B. And let me show you how output is coming. So inputs are 00, 01, 10 and 11. And output of XOR gate, that will be as per 0, 1, 1, 0, right? I hope you know how truth table is there with XOR gate. Now, if you carefully observe over here, what is my output? So during C is equals to 0, what is my output? You see, output Y, that is similar to B. So I can say when C is 0, output Y, that is equals to B. And when C is 1, if you observe, output Y, that is invert of input B. Right. So here output Y, that is B bar. So my dear students, This is what the property that we will be using over here. You see what we are doing over here. When this C is 0, at the time this B that will be input to this full adder. But when this C that is 1, at the time B bar will be input to this full adder, right? And see, these are the full adders that we are having. So if you draw further circuit, then what will be my further circuit? You see, this C that will be carry input to this full adder. Now whatever carry that is generated by this full adder, that will be given to this full adder. Whatever carry that is generated by this full adder, that will be given to this full adder. That is how we will be giving carry to next full adder. And this is my final C out carry, right? And my outputs are as per Z0, Z1, Z2, and Z3. So see what is happening here. When this C is 0, let me write over here, when this C that is 0, at that time this XOR gate that will be having output, you see, that will be as per second input. Second input is B over here. So output will be over here as per B0, B1, B2 and B3. And you see this carry is 0. So this output Z, you see this output Z, that is as per simply full adder addition, right? That will be A plus B, right? This is A0 and B0, that addition will be coming over here, right? And this carry again A1 plus B1 that will come over here. So this Z that will be A plus B in case of C is equals to 0. But what will happen as if C is equals to 1? So in that situation, you see what is happening. As per XOR gate, when C is 1, at the time output is Y is equals to B bar. So when C is 1, at the time XOR gate output, that will be B0 bar over here, B1 bar over here, B2 bar over here and B3 bar over here, right? That is how output will come. So at that time, you see this full adder output, that will be A plus B bar plus this carry is equals to 1. So you see Z is equals to A plus B bar plus carry is equals to 1. What it means, here we are performing subtraction operation. So this is how 4-bit adder subtractor circuit that we can have. And already for 1-bit subtraction, I have made one video. You see my previous video that was there based on 1-bit subtractor, right? That we have made it by using full adder only. So if you go through this video even, that will also gives you more clarity regarding how exactly we are using property of XOR gate. So same thing that I have done over here for 4-bit subtraction, right? And I have made this video based on the request of one of my students. He told me, like, you have explained 1-bit subtractor. Can you explain that for 4-bit subtractor? I have told in that video also, like, things are same, only you need to extend the circuit. So here I have shown how extension of circuit is there, right? Still, if anything that you would like to share it with me, please note it down in the comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.